Thank you, Your Excellency. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Your Excellencies, honourable guests, distinguished audience, I would like to thank you for inviting me to this important global forum that represents a great opportunity for me and for us to exchange ideas and experiences. Hopefully together we will be able to develop strategies which will pave the way toward equal citizenship rights for Muslims and Christians anywhere and everywhere in the world. Irrespective of national identity, all citizens need to be granted equally universal human rights. Our states need to protect these human rights. To grant equal protection, we need to rethink our Christian-Muslim dialogue. It is only through engaging in dialogue and accepting the diversity of each other that we can reach a peaceful reconciliation. As Christians and Muslims, we share the fundamental value of human dignity that is central to our scriptural and theological traditions and forms an integral part of our moral fabrics. Through its all-encompassing legislation, the United Arab Emirates has cemented the role of equal citizenship in its society. The Constitution guarantees the rights of all individuals to practice as equal their religious rights. In 2015, the UAE has enacted the anti-discrimination law, which criminalizes all forms of discrimination, regardless of religion, race, ethnicity, or gender. Citizens and residents of the UAE can freely engage in dialogue and debate and discuss their diverse ethical beliefs and convictions. This freedom of belief and debate has largely contributed to the great economic, cultural, and social success of the UAE over the last 45 years. Your Excellencies, the core message of divine religions is a message of love. We all share same teachings of justice, social equality, compassion, respect, peace, and non-violence. Muslim-Christian dialogue dates back to the rise of Islam in the 7th century. We share a common heritage for more than 14 centuries. Our communities of faith have been linked to their theological understandings and by geographical proximity. Religious pluralism and civic rights were the core pillars of Muslim nation, the Ummah. Under Islam, Prophet Muhammad has established a pluralistic society in which citizenship and equal rights were granted to all people, regardless of their religious beliefs and practices. The covenants of Prophet Muhammad with the Christians of his time reflect egalitarian, democratic partnership between Muslims and Christians. Islam emphasizes social justice, individual freedom, and social equality. This leads us to emphasize tolerance as an essential value in which Islam is based and as a way of living. Today, we have more than 120 churches established in the UAE, in addition to the Middle East Council of Churches, which gathers under its roof all the churches existing in the country, where fellow Christian worshippers of all colors and stripes can fulfill their rituals. With more than 200 nationalities living in the country, the UAE shares the universal responsibility to respect cultural diversity. In order to foster tolerance in our society, the UAE had created the world number one ministerial post for tolerance. This has been instrumental in leading various initiatives, such as establishing the National Program for Tolerance, through which the UAE society will continue to build up tolerance and nurture the culture of acceptance of the other. In addition, the UAE has implemented various initiatives to consolidate the values of tolerance as integral traits in society. Some of these initiatives I mention: the International Institute for Tolerance, the Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Award for Tolerance, which aims, among other things, to support Arab researchers and international specialists in the field of tolerance, in addition to a multitude of other initiatives and activities. In conclusion, I would like to encourage us all to work together to build more tolerant, peaceful, and coexisting societies for our present and for the future generations. Thank you.